On the first episode of Hidden Jewels, we go deep into the summer of 2017 to discuss the underdog story of that year, Patti Cakes.
In the family jewel?
In the family jewel, man!
Music video director Jeremy Jasper emerges onto the scene with the feature-length film Patti Cakes. What he gives us is a fresh, hilarious, inspiring, heartbreaking, and all-out entertaining film that gives us a main character that we've most likely never seen grace the screen before. And in this character, we're giving many things to root for. Patricia Dombrowski, played magnificently by Danielle McDonald, is the underdog we are all hoping to get out of Eminem's B-Rabbit in 2002's 8 Mile. However, where that character came off as whiny, broody, and bitchy, Patricia is the opposite. She's got a hell of a hard life, trust me. Being borderline obese, growing up without a father, living with a drunken mother stuck in her 80s hairband days, and left with most of the burden of the bills and taking care of her dying grandmother, Patricia's life when we first meet her is grueling. As we learn more about her, we find that as she's burdened with these hardships, she's not out to blame the world for them. She uses her daydreams of becoming a famous rap artist to get her through her awful days. Her typical day is working two jobs, being called Dumbo everywhere she goes, and finally finishing off the evening in a bathroom stall, holding her drunk mother's hair back from the possible path of vomit. Through all this, Patricia never lets her head fall too far. She uses insults and things she hears about herself to help her write her rap songs. Her best friend, played by Siddharth Dahanye, almost steals the film as her trusty sidekick. They both share the dream of becoming a hip-hop group together.
Introducing Miss Patricia Dombrowski, aka Patti Cakes, aka White Trish, aka Juicy Luciano, aka...
As he uses his talents to set beats and do backup with autotune, his main focus is to keep Patricia inspired.
Jose, can let me go in, it's the Jeromeo remix, come on, let's get it.
Nope.
He believes in her and knows her talents and doesn't let the assholes around town bother her or their ultimate goal. They eventually meet a strange but poetic and interesting musician who calls himself Bastard the Antichrist, looking a little like Tintin straight out of The Crow. The three of them click musically, and along with Patricia's grandmother, played beautifully by Kathy Moriarty, they put together a demo under the name PB&J. That will stick with you so long after you watch this movie. The recording scenes where we get to hear Patricia's talents as a rapper are incredible, and pretty much the highlights of the film. Are there parallels to Curtis Hanson's 8 Mile? A few, but for the most part it's its own film. It's an underdog story about an individual in a downtrodden town who wants to be a rapper. Other than that, this is pretty much its own film, and a much stronger one, with a stronger main character that we have possibly never seen before and actually want to get behind. McDonald is a revelation here. She is so natural and handles even the hardest of scenes like a seasoned vet. And dare I say, she gave one of the best performances by a lead actress that year. She is funny and witty when it calls for it. She shows us true sadness and devastation in certain parts. The overall character arc was written by Jasper, but it takes pure raw talent to showcase it on screen, and Patricia, aka Killa B, aka Patti Cakes, is the perfect embodiment of inspiration in the face of true tragedy. Jeremy Jasper's direction is awesome. The decisions he makes early on in the film sets the ground for the type of film we're about to watch and the overall tone. Because this film is essentially a comedy drama, it hits you hard with some real gut punches involving the way Patricia is seen and treated around town by her mother at work. But then, before things get too heavy or depressing, it's spiked with some truly effective levity that breaks the tension and keeps the film so fucking enjoyable and, dare I say, hilarious sometimes. It's hard to take your eyes off this film. Jasper staged just some truly hilarious dream sequences that are obvious calls to his roots as a music video director. Knowing the industry for which his protagonist is trying to break into, you feel the harsh reality of it all. Jasper wrote all the musical numbers for this, and trust me when I tell you, they are awesome. Hip hop doesn't sound like this anymore.
I look better when I dance, have you looking at it, put you in a...
The direction, pacing, and editing are all done very well with just enough artistry to not feel overbearing, and with the right amount of depth to service the storytelling perfectly. All the performances of the film are great, with McDonald leading the charge. Her mother, played by Bridget Everett, is excellent as well, really selling the down-in-the-dumps atmosphere of the situation. This is a shining moment for Danielle McDonald. She is truly something special to watch. I will continue to say how easily this character could have just been droll and dispirited, but instead, we fall in love with her within within minutes and truly start to root for her, not in a way of pity, but because she's a smart and talented person with a huge heart, a big mouth, and a keen sense of responsibility. She's also pretty damn hilarious in the face of it all. It's a crowd pleaser with its own sense of the term. It's not formulaic or overly gushy. It's unpredictable and unique. Some sequences feel so real, and then some other ones feel straight out of a fantasy. Jasper has a great future with feature films. He knows hip-hop, and he's a lover of hip-hop. I was floored by some of the sequences. Go out and find Patti Cakes. As always, if you like this review, please click like and or subscribe to Cinema Gulp today. It's the Ritz Cracker, a Gohan swagger is Viagra. I roll stone through Jersey like Jagger in a Jaguar. I pull strings like Santana at the Copacabana. Tony Montana meets Soprano in a pink bandana. I wax that ass like a Brazilian, make a million hits. Frick through a nest, I'm fresh to death, flow till I'm filthy rich. Big mojo jet with the black hot white Trish is the ish. Left from the black shack like a Tampax, we up in this bitch. The beast of the posse, the beast of the back.